To give you the best of myself.
Oh, and to ask if you know more than you can give. I promise to respect you as your own person.
And to realize that your interests, desires, and needs are no less important than my own. I promise to share with you my time and attention.
And to bring joy, strength, and imagination to our relationship. I promise to keep myself open to you.
To let you see through the window of my world into my innermost fears and feelings, secrets and dreams. I promise to grow along with you.
Be willing to face changes in order to keep our relationship alive and exciting.
I promise to love you in good times and in bad.
With all that I have to give and all that I feel inside in the only way I know how.
Completely and forever.
Completely and forever.
Jenny, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness. As I place it on your finger, I commit my heart and soul to you. I choose you to be my wife this day and forevermore.
Tony, I give you this ring, the symbol of my love and faithfulness. As I place it on your finger, I commit my heart and soul to you. I choose you to be my husband this day and forevermore.
Tony, do you take Jenny to be your lawfully wedded wife? To have and to hold from this day forward? For better or worse, richer or poorer, in sickness and in health? To love and cherish, forsaking all others from this day forward until death do you part?
I do.
And Jenny, do you take Tony to be your lawfully wedded husband? To have and to hold from this day forward for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health?
I do.
Good. Oh. Cherishing in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, forsaking all others. An important part. And until death do you part?
I do that part too.
Well, by the power vested in me in the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Baby, you're all that I want. When you lie. When Cody was in about second or third grade, he was really into Indians. And so he wanted to get a mohawk haircut. And we said, sure, that's fine. And so he went into school one day and told everybody he was going to get a mohawk. And his teacher told him, no, he couldn't do that because it would be disruptive. So he came home that night, told us that, and I said, you're getting that haircut tonight. And he did. And so he went to school and had a mohawk for the rest of that spring school year. And that's the last time you've done that, isn't it?
Tony came skiing with us one year. It was snowing like crazy. He was wearing a pair of sandals. His luggage consisted of his friend Robert and a bottle of brandy.
We met up in Alaska, and I didn't have any sort of ride. We met at work, and so I quickly made friends with Tony because he had this really awesome Audi at the time that he bought from a zookeeper in Alaska. And so because of Tony, I got to be about a foot away from the biggest polar bear I've ever seen in my life. It was an amazing experience, and I thank you for that, and also giving me lots of rides to work and whatnot. As far as advice goes, learn to laugh at things that aren't that funny.
I'm not related to Tony, but I knew him before he owned any BMWs, and I was on my Ford, which I still have. It's a 25-year-old dog of a car. Nothing like Tony's, but hey, I knew him when he was just driving Audis.
So our good friend, he brought us all together to our girl hockey. And she's always a life of the party, she's so much fun. I remember a couple years ago at her birthday party, we went all to the Shop House in San Diego, which is a really piano bar. And we told the bartenders, the pianist, that it was her birthday, so they called her up on stage to sing happy birthday to her. And she was feeling super feisty and jumped right up on the piano while they sang to her. So our story is that Tony was working in Alaska, and it was a cold winter night, and it was not a woman in 50 miles. And here comes Janet, she's off the plane, and she's in all the way around. So Tony fought off every other man in town to win the prize, and he killed the moose for her. But he had his skin and gave her the meat. Sorry, Linda, if I've embarrassed you.
All I know is if Tony takes care of the kids as good as his car, so we won't have any problems with them. And while you're gone, if you need to go look after either of those cars, I am a certified driver now.
And second place.
Eight of them in, all of them, a couple months with the good cars, and those tires.
Wishes. About a year ago, Tony called and asked if he could see us. And we kind of had an idea of what was going on. You know, they were talking about getting married, but we weren't really sure. So Tony came up. About the time we sat down for lunch, he said, you know, Jenny has made me happier than anyone else in my whole life. And I want to spend the rest of my life making her just as happy. And I looked at him and I said, well, as long as you put it that way, how can I say no?